I'm Henny, Mitutoyo's Data Management and Measurlink Sales Engineer. And today we'll be talking about 5 tips you didn't know about Measurlink, plus 1 bonus tip. Our first tip is going to be in the support center. We're going to look at the copy and paste. So let's go ahead and take a look at XYZ123. And we have this thickness characteristic, and maybe we're going to take lots of thicknesses on this one part. They're all going to have the same nominal. They're all going to have the same tolerances. We don't want to enter in this information over and over and over again. Instead, we can hit copy, go ahead and click back on the part, and hit paste. And we can continue to paste in as many of these characteristics as we need to. If there needs to be a little adjustment made, maybe the nominal is going to shift for a certain characteristic, that's no problem. What you can also do is copy the entire part. Hit copy on the part, go to the folder that you're interested in pasting it into, and there you have it. Now you have a new part that's called XYZ123_2. You can make any changes you need to there. Anything that you can right click on in the support center, you can probably copy it and paste it to help you save time. Tip number 2 is going to be our folder options in the routine library. Going into the routine library here, you can set up default routine options. For example, the collection method. Are you going to collect an entire part in its entirety, length, width, OD, ID, etc.? Or are you going to have 10 parts at a time and measure the ID of all of them before you move on to the OD and so on? So you can set up a default collection method. You can set up a default serial number being forest, or any of these options you can set as a default. Or you can set that at the folder level as well. So if you have a specific folder, you can go ahead and change those options. And any routine you create under that folder or under the root folder, you'll be able to see all of those options apply to those new routines. My third is going to be trigger reports. So we can go to any of our routines here that we're interested in measuring. Let's go ahead to this 2869. routine, and we have this tab here going to be under report options. Under this report options, we can enable a default report. So when we go and we do the measurement routine of this final inspection, for example, we can say which report we're interested in printing out, for example. So we can create what's also called going to be a trigger report. So at the end of every part, am I going to display a report to it? Or am I going to print it out to a printer or a PDF, for example? Or do I only want these reports printed or sent out when I have a defective part? Or after X amount of parts, then I'm going to want to send out a report. So this is going to be a very quick, easy way to set up a default option using trigger reports to send out reports on demand. Tip number 4 is going to be mapping. So let's go ahead and take a look at this routine that we have over here. We have a lot of different characteristics, and our DAQ source is empty. If your DAQ source is going to be the same for every characteristic, go ahead and click on the dropdown, find the DAQ source that you're interested in, and right-click on it and hit Map All Characteristics. Now you don't have to go through each and every one now, and it's all mapped for you. In addition to the mapping all characteristics, you can also copy mapping to additional stations. So if you have multiple stations where you're going to be doing this inspection and you want to apply that to these other stations without having to go ahead and actually do them, you can click copy, and now those stations are mapped and will be ready for data collection there. Tip number 5 is going to be global options. Let's go back into Measurlink here under File, Options. And we'll see here the number of decimal places. I have mine set to 4. By default, they come in as 6 when you first get Measurlink. You may not want to have that many decimal places be the default, so you can change that to be higher or lower if you need to. And then, of course, you can always change the characteristic or the part individually if you need them to be larger or smaller. This is just setting up your default decimal places. You can also change the limit style. Rather than be absolute, you can have it be relative. So if you know that your parts are going to be plus or minus 5 thou or 1 thou, you can have it be relative, and all you need to do is put in the plus minus value. Lastly, we have chart options. If we take a look at our charts here under position offset here, we have lots of data points and these sort of big data points here. So we can either change the size, the shape, the color of the data points, or we can change the number of subgroups displayed, or both. By default, they're going to auto-size, so the more data you take, Measurlink is going to fit more and more data points onto your chart. If you're only interested in seeing, let's say, the last 5 or 10 subgroups, you can simply and easily just press in 10, save to the station, or save globally everywhere in your factory. And we have a bonus tip for you as well. It's going to be my favorite tip of them all, electronic data collection. Here we have our caliper using U-Wave Bluetooth. It's a Bluetooth transmitter with connection unit that can send data directly to Measurlink. We can go ahead and take our data point here, hit the button, and the data goes right into Measurlink, saving you lots of time and money in the process. Using whether it's our U-Wave Bluetooth, our wired systems, or any system that can send data directly to a computer, you can collect that with Measurlink and definitely save lots of time. Go ahead and check out our other YouTube video on the electronic data collection speed test for more information. Thank you.